The Iranians were planning the missile tests before President Obama accused them of hiding a nuclear site. So today's shots were not so much an act of defiance as a reminder of the stakes. A missile which could someday carry a nuclear warhead flew southeast from its launch site and splashed into the ocean, a distance that could reach Israel and parts of Europe. In case anybody missed the point, Iran's defense minister vowed Israel's days are numbered. For the moment, however, Iran is not a nuclear power, but an oil power, and the U.S. is preparing sanctions that would cut off sales of oil-producing technology.
To really have an impact on Iran, you have to have an impact on this ability to export oil at substantial levels.
Ray Takeh of the Council of Foreign Relations says that for sanctions to work, Russia and China have to go along, and China in particular will be reluctant.
Because the Chinese are actually investors in Iran, in Iran's petroleum sector, and also consumers of Iran petroleum products. So they might have some hesitation in terms of really imposing rigorous sanctions on Iran petroleum sector.
But the White House says the discovery of this secret uranium enrichment plant dug into the side of a mountain has finally awakened everybody to the threat posed by Iran.
There has never been a stronger international consensus to address Iran and its nuclear weapons program than there is right now.
U.S. and European officials will meet with the Iranians on Thursday to hear their explanation for the facility. Takeh predicts they will claim they have done nothing wrong.
They're going to make the claim that they were not obligated to declare the site because no nuclear material has been introduced.
Iran already has said it will allow international inspectors to visit the site, much as they have done with their other enrichment plant at Natanz, which they claim will only produce fuel for nuclear energy.
If sanctions don't work, the U.S. or Israel could launch airstrikes to destroy Iran's nuclear plants. But Defense Secretary Gates says that would only set Iran back by 1 to 3 years. So for now, construction at that once secret site continues. Harry?
David Martin at the Pentagon tonight. Thank you. The UN has already slapped a number of sanctions on Iran, including restrictions on the import and export of arms and nuclear technology, travel bans for those who work in the nuclear program, including scientists. Some financial assets have been frozen, and some of Iran's air and sea cargo can be inspected. Juan Zarate is a former deputy national security advisor for combating terrorism and now a national security analyst for CBS News. Juan, good evening.
Good evening, Harry.
These sanctions have not been particularly effective in the past. What would make new ones work?
Well, in the first point, I think the sanctions have been watered down in the past, largely to accommodate China and Russia. I think there are very clear points of leverage, though, if there's political will to enforce these sanctions in the banking sector, in the inspections of cargo and shipments, and in particular with gas imports upon which Iran relies heavily. And so if there's the political will, there are points of leverage with respect to these sanctions.
The key to this really seems to be Russia and China. You got movement last week from Medvedev saying that some sanctions might be inevitable. Are they on board this time around?
Well, we're certainly seeing very good signals from the Russians, but the key will be the Thursday meeting, the meeting with the Iranians on October 1st, where the Iranians now have the onus to explain themselves to the international community. And that then, I think, will set the table for whether or not sanctions and harsher sanctions will be put in place.